Hey, what's up YouTube? In this video, I'll be showing you how to make Steven's house from the show Steven Universe. This has been a very popular request and I'm very happy to have finally fulfilled it. I hope that you guys enjoy this as well. You can show me by hitting that like button. I'd really, really appreciate that. And not only should you give the video a like, I'd really appreciate it like I just said, but if you do that, please do leave a suggestion down below as to what I should make next. Well, that any further ado, let me show you how to make this thing. So to begin, this is the amount of space that the house will roughly take up. That's 28 blocks across by 23 blocks backwards. Of course, this may take up more space if we decide to add more to the surrounding area, or unless you build a big giant mountain behind it. We also need all of these materials that you can see in the inventory right now. I'm going to begin by grabbing the entire top row, although we will need all of them, and perhaps even more. Take a moment, grab them all. Once you've got them all, once you've got enough space, we can begin. So we're going to start off with a row of 4 spruceable plants coming up from the ground. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then, using white concrete, we'll go up by 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We then want to go right by 1, do an upright diagonal, right by 1, upright diagonal, right by 1, upright diagonal, right 1, upright diagonal, right 1, and one final upright diagonal. Now, just before we continue on, I will show you that you want to have this, because we have done quite a few steps. Once you have that, we then want to take that last diagonal and we want to go down by 3. 1, 2, 3. Then right by 2, 1, 2, do a bottom right diagonal, right 1, do a bottom right diagonal, go right by 1, and then we want to go down by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can then connect that 5th block all the way down to the ground using spruce planks, like this. We then want to beginning from the very first white concrete that we place, which is this one, as you guys might remember. We want to take this white concrete and we want to go right of it by 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We then want to place a red concrete, go up on top of that by 3, 1, 2, 3. Go right by 2, 1, 2. Go down by 3, 1, 2, and 3. And what we want to do here, we want to do a couple of things. First, place a light blue stained glass underneath the top middle part of this. Place spruce wood slabs coming across the top of the door. You then want to place an entire row of white concrete going right of the door area. You then want to go right of the top white concrete by 2 of the glass, 1, 2. We then want to place a spruce wood plank and then place 2 additional glass, 1, 2. We are then going to place 2 more rows of this underneath itself. So 2 rows of glass underneath every single glass and 2 rows of spruce wood planks underneath all of the spruce wood planks. To which we then want to place spruce wood slabs on it, like in front of the bottom of the window and also in front of the top of the window too. What we can then do is we can actually fill in the entire front of the house using white concrete. Now, it's going to be quite obvious where you want to fill in. You don't want to fill in the door, and you want to fill in just the area underneath the window to create a nice solid surface. What you could even do is place an entire row of spruce wood slab underneath where the door is, just so that you now have like kind of like a frame to work with. That might help you, it might not. We're then going to continue to fill in the entire rest of the front of the house using our white concrete, and we might actually do something a bit premature in that once we filled this in using our white concrete, I think I'm going to add the door, which is just a simple iron door. It goes right underneath the glass, and there is also like a torch slash lantern next to the door, which we're going to use a torch for, an item frame, and we're also going to use a spruce plank. So going left of the glass from the door, you want to simply leave a gap of 1, so not that block but this one, place a torch on the wall, item frame behind the torch and a spruce plank inside the item frame. And that is supposed to be like an outdoor lantern slash light source sort of thing. You can't really make what is actually on the house, so you know, you do the best with what you have. So that's the front of the house anyway. And once you've completed the front of the house, what we're going to do is we're going to make the sides of the house. So grab your white concrete, and you also need the glass, and we can start this off. So the left-hand side of the house, what we want to do is we want to take the entire left wall, and we want to extend it going backwards by 12 rows using the white concrete. It'll look like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And of course, all of those rows want to be the same. So we want to do 12 rows of white concrete coming across the back of the house, and this will form the left wall. Now, the left wall of the house is not without its detail. I'll show you in a second. So that is the left-hand wall of the house complete. The only thing we have to add to it is windows. So take the top front right-hand corner of the shape. So this is right at the front of the house. It's the most upward front block, and from this block you want to move left by 2 towards the back, 1, 2, move down 1, destroy that block, destroy the 2 to the left, 1, 2, gap of 1, destroy 3 going back, 1, 2, 3, and then destroy the blocks underneath the blocks that you just destroyed, like this. And then you can proceed to simply just fill those in using light blue glass. Now, once you've done that, we want to come to the opposite side of the house this time, and we want to take this wall on the opposite side of the house, and we want to extend this wall backwards by 12 rows. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and this time we are not actually going to destroy, don't worry, we're not going to destroy any of this particular part of the house, because from what I can tell, from what I've observed, there's no windows, so you don't really have to worry about that at all. So there we go, that's what we want to have. Another part of the house that we are going to extend backwards is that we are going to take the very top of the house, which is here, like the very top middle part of the house, and we also want to extend this backwards by 12 as well. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then we want to extend this down, and we actually want to be able to connect it to both sides of the back of the house, like this. And what you can even do is you can just build up the wall at the back of the house, and you can just add rows and rows of white concrete coming up the back of the house until these rows of concrete are even and smooth with the left-hand side and the right-hand side walls of the house, like this. So you can just build it up like that. But once you've done that, what we actually want to do is we want to copy the front of the house. So you can see on the front of the house where we have all of those ridges. We want these on the back as well. The best way that I can describe to do this is literally look directly forwards and just copy them. So if you look forwards at the front of the house, you just want to copy what you have on the front onto the back. It's probably the easiest way of doing it. Just make sure that it's right. You'll be able to tell just by looking. So that's the right hand side, and we want to do the same thing on the left hand side as well. And that looks about right to me. So just copy the front onto the back. It's not very far. You'll be able to do it without too much trouble. What we also want to do is we want to, using our light blue glass, we want to take the very top row of white concrete that connects the front of the house to the back of the house, and we want to place two rows of glass underneath it. So this will be one row underneath, and this will be the second row directly underneath. So we want to have something which should look like that. Very simple, really. Now, once you've got that sorted out, ladies and gentlemen, what we're now going to do is we are going to place a layer of spruce wood slab that goes all the way around the bottom of the house. So we want to place a layer of spruce wood slab that goes all the way around the bottom of the house like this. And we simply want to connect the corners of that down to the ground. So we want to connect each one of the particular corners of the house down to the ground, very much how we did at the very start of the video, like that. And then, just so that we have a floor, because, I mean, nobody wants to walk around a house that doesn't have a floor. Number one, you'd fall straight through it. I mean, this house is elevated. Maybe you could get away with it if you lived on, like, solid land, but this is like a beach house. You can't really be walking around on, like, an elevated, stilted house. You'll fall straight through. It's no good. And then you get caught in quicksand, and then what do you do? Exactly. So, we're just going to fill the bottom of this house in using our spruce wood slabs, and then we will work on the roof of the house, which is very, very simple as well. I'm sure that we won't have too much trouble with it either. It's actually kind of a cool roof. I really like these particular designs of roof. You guys will be able to see what I'm talking about in just a moment, of course, once we have done the floor. There we go. Perfect. So this is what we have so far. It's looking a bit basic, but it's going to look a lot better. So what we're going to do now, very simple stuff. On the very left-hand side of the house, right, we want to place a row of spruce wood slabs that is on the very left-hand side of the house. It goes from the front to the back, like that, yeah? If that makes sense. Spruce wood slabs on the left-hand side of the house, going straight across. You want to take the first spruce wood slab and extend it towards you by one. And then you want to extend the slab to the right by one. Up one, right one, up one, right one, up one, right one, up one, right one, up one. You guys get the idea, right? It's right one, up one, right one, up one. And we are eventually going to stop when it is logical to do so, because we should get to a point where when we eventually place that last right one, like this, it is overhanging the top middle part of the house. And then we're going to extend that part that overhangs the house. We're going to extend it backwards, right? All the way back until it overhangs the back of the house. Then we're going to do pretty much the same thing that we've just done on the front, but on the back, reversed. So we'll take this block that overhangs, we'll go right one, down one, right one, down one, right, down, right, down, right, whoops, right down. You guys get the idea. We simply just go all the way down until we eventually, and we will eventually, connect to the opposite side of the back of the house. There we go. Very nice. And we're just going to then connect the, we're going to connect the relevant spruce wood slabs to the front, from the front of the house to the back of the house. We're just going to fill in the roof a little bit. We also have to do the roof on the right-hand side of the house. As you guys might have seen, there is a nice big exposed bit of the house, which we will very easily be able to take care of using our spruce wood slabs. But there's more details to add to this part of the roof before we move on to that opposite side. For instance, there's a chimney, and there is a particular part of the roof that overhangs that needs detail adding to it. That's what we'll be doing first before the chimney. So far, we want to have something which should look like this, and as you can see, the house has already been improved. Wonderful. So, on the right-hand side of the house, where we have the overhanging part of the roof, what you basically want to do is you want to start one block in from the edge of the roof, so right here, and you want to place a spruce wood slab underneath this. Miss one, going back, place one. Miss one, place one. Miss one, whoops. Miss one, place one. Coming all the way back to the house. So very much like that. It's really simple stuff. Easy to do, looks good, and is factually correct with the actual roof in the program. We also have to add a chimney. So chimney is made very much of just light grey concrete and cobblestone wall. Grab both of those. On the left hand side of the house, you'll notice that we have two windows and a row of white concrete in between them. Well, using the middle row of white concrete, we want to move up, and we want to find, as we move up from this middle part of the white concrete, we want to move up onto the roof, and we want to count in by one block, two block, three blocks. Destroy this. Place a light grey concrete, one on top, with two cobblestone wall. One, two, on top of that. So as you can see, that plants it very firmly in between those two windows, three in, and it just looks nice and right in that position. Once you've got that sorted out, we're going to tackle the other side of the roof. So this is a bit smaller. On the right hand side of the house, we want to begin by placing a row of spruce wood slabs on the upper outside of the right hand side of the house. It's the same thing that we did on the opposite end. We then want to extend the spruce wood slab towards us by one row, and then we want to extend it left one, up one, 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 left one. And do we want to do an up? No, we'll leave it at left one. And all we have to do really is we just then have to come all the way to the back, and we just want to do the same thing. So we want to take this block, make it overhang, come towards us, then right one, up one, 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 right one. And then all we have to do, of course, just connect the front to the back. Very simple, looks great. Looks very nice. This is most of the house complete as well, by the way, guys. If you haven't noticed, I'm sure you have. This is a lot of the house complete. And once we have got this particular part of the house done, we have a big giant decking to add. So this thing is, of course, suspended on some decking. It's got it's basically on stilts. So once you've got that sorted out, and that looks great, by the way, loving how that looks. Okay, so the house is looking really good, but it is missing one really important thing. This house has a lot of decking built around it, and as a matter of fact, that's how you actually get up to the house itself. So grab the spruce wood slabs, and we want to begin. Can you remember when we placed that row of spruce wood slabs in front of the bottom of the house, kind of like just underneath it? Well, we want to take that entire row of spruce wood slabs, and we want to place five rows of slabs coming in front of this row. So just to show you, this is going to be one row just coming out in front, then two rows now, and then three rows, and then four rows, and then five rows coming out in front of the house just like that. We then want to come to the left hand side of the house. We want to have the same thing, except we want to do four rows on the side. So on this left hand side, we want to do, this is going to be one row, very long process. Then this will be two rows once it's done. Then three rows, right about there. And then four rows coming out of the left hand side of the house. The back of the house is slightly different in that we want to do three rows. So the back of the house, we want to do one row. This is going to be the longest out of all of them. And then two rows, the second longest out of all of them. And then three rows coming out of the back of the house. So we want to have three rows. All that leaves is the right hand side of the house, in which we want to have seven rows coming out of the side of it. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And we want to build all of those. Now, the reason that I have placed that row of seven is to make sure that that is a row of seven that we're going to be building, because it's very important that these measurements are correct, as we will be building railings going all the way around the outside of the decking. If the measurements that we've just placed are not correct, then the railings will not add up and they'll look extremely weird. So the best way to avoid it is to count them properly or alter the decking later as we place the railings. But so far, that's what we want to have. We want to have a nice big decking area. So then we want to place, starting in front of the, come all the way to the front left hand side of the decking, this corner here, we want to place a row of seven spruce wood slabs going in front of this part of the decking to the right. We want to place 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then place two additional rows in front of this. This is going to be one row and two rows. Now we want to grab our birchwood fence, and we want to place a birchwood fence on top of the front left-hand corner of the decking. And we also want to place, going right, we want to leave a gap of one, place a fence, gap of one, place a fence, gap of one, place a fence. we also want to take that first fence and we want to move backwards from it. So moving backwards around the edge of the decking, we want to leave a gap, place a fence. Gap, fence, gap, fence, gap, fence. You guys get the idea, I'm sure you do. And we want to go all the way around the edge of the decking, and somehow we've managed to mess this up. It's okay though, because all we have to do now is just simply add an additional row of spruce wood slabs to the back of the decking, and that should be fine. So just add an additional row of spruce wood slabs if your fence doesn't fit, and continue adding the birchwood fence. And then go around just continue going around the edge with the birchwood fence, and we are just going to hope and pray that the actual fence does fit, to which it does not. So the best way to do this is simply to add just an additional row of spruce wood slabs on the right hand side, just to make sure that it fits. There's no shame in being wrong here, so we just want to add that, and then we want to gradually come towards the front of the decking like this. You know, it's a real shame that, okay, that's annoying, isn't it? So I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll now shave a bit of the decking here. We'll just shave a bit of the decking so that the fence actually fits, just like that. This is something that you encounter when you build stuff like this. Sometimes you get measurements wrong. Sometimes things don't work out. That's an easy way to solve it. Just simply shave a little bit off the decking, add a little bit just to make sure that it works. Now, just to make sure that this actually does fit, we're now going to take this corner and we're going to follow the pattern around, and we want to follow the pattern of fence, gap, etc, etc, and we want to follow it coming all the way over to the left here like this, and the fence actually wants to stop right there. So you can see that we now have a nice bit of fencing going around the top of the decking. And now all we want to do is we want to, using birch wood slabs, we just want to place a row of birch wood slabs that goes all the way around on top of the birch wood fence. I'm really, really annoyed that the decking actually didn't fit, or the railings for the decking didn't fit. I thought that my measurements were perfect, actually. I really did. I didn't think that we'd have to make any alterations, never mind three of them. But This is kind of what happens sometimes. Sometimes, you know, you accidentally add a little here, you take a little there, and, you know, things don't go perfect, but you end up with the same result anyway. We want to do two more things. So we want to add stairs to the decking. Where we have this row of four here, we want to place a row of stairs connecting from the decking all the way down to the ground. So we just want to connect decking to the ground, ground to the decking, however it is you want to look at it. So we just want to add rows of stairs. The best thing to do is simply to add a frame first, and then the rest should take care of itself like that. Then we have a nice set of stairs leading down to the ground. We also want to connect each one of the four corners of the decking down to the ground. So this front left hand corner, for instance, we want to connect it down to the ground. This back left-hand corner, again, down to the ground like this, using a mixture of slabs and planks, just like that. And the front right-hand corner also, we want to connect down to the ground. Missed the mark there a little bit, there we go. And we should end up with something that should look exactly like that, which is looking very, very nice. Now, that all that means, does that make sense? All that means is that we want to add now, on the right-hand side of the decking, a little bit of a seating area, which is made out of quartz stairs, end rods, quartz slabs, and yellow carpet. This decking stuff has really got my brain frazzled. I just can't talk anymore. So what we now want to do, on the right-hand side of the house, somewhere in the middle, or maybe even towards the front so we can see it, we want to make a bit of a table. This is going to be a 3x3 row of quartz slabs on the decking somewhere. So like 1, 2, 3, and then one row, two rows. Maybe even like one row closer to the house. So we just want to have a 3x3 row of quartz slabs. We're then going to add another row of slabs on top to make those quartz blocks. We're going to add seats by placing quartz stairs in the front middle and the front back. We're going to place two end rods coming up from the ground. One and two, well, from the middle of the table, actually. We then want to place quartz slabs going all the way around the second end rod, all the way around the top like this. We then want to place yellow carpet on top of these slabs with a quartz slab on top of the center block. And that is pretty much most of the house. There's only one more thing that I would add. It's almost complete. It really is. All I would add is some jungle leaves around the base of the decking. So like the front right hand corner, I'd add a little bit of jungle leaves, right? Just like this, just to add a little bit of character. I'd also add a lot of jungle leaves kind of like going around from that leg. I'd kind of like have it go round the back like this, kind of placing them a little bit randomly so that it looks rather natural. From this leg all the way to the back left hand corner leg. And this just, you know, because it's just elevated and all by itself, and because we're not building this on a beach with like raised ground and stuff, although that is where I would build it, by the way, if you have the choice and you're not just in like creative worlds like me, I would absolutely build this in like a beach on like uneven surfaces so that it would look a little bit nicer. If you place a little bit of jungle leafage like this, you will get a very nice effect, and it really breaks up the area underneath the decking like this. It just breaks up a little bit. It makes it look a little bit better. You can even place some around the stairs as well, like at the base of the stairs. And perhaps you can even place a little bit around some of the legs around here. Again, this would be better built upon like uneven ground so that it looks a little bit better. But you know, we're doing pretty well with what we have here. And that's actually the last little detail that I would add to Stephen's house. It looks really nice like this. I think I've got it pretty close. I don't think that I've really missed anything much, or maybe even at all. If there are little details that I have missed, I do apologize, but hopefully you guys can just add those yourselves and make the house complete for you. But I think I'm hoping that I've done a decent job. If you guys have enjoyed this tutorial, please do remember to hit that like button. I'd really, really appreciate that. I honestly would. If you do enjoy the content, please hit that like button. If you've liked this, please like it. Subscribe to the channel if you would like to see more by me. And also click the little bell next to the subscription button. That'll make sure that you get all my stuff sent directly to your sub box. And if you do like the video, please consider leaving a suggestion down below. Leave a suggestion with your like. It helps out a lot. I wouldn't have built this if it hadn't have been for suggestions. And if you do want to check out any more of my stuff, we're kind of in a cartoony part of my world right now. You can check that in the card system in the description below. I would heavily recommend the Cartoon Builds playlist, although I'll leave a few more for you to check out as well, because we don't just do cartoon stuff. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video.